Students, protocol to you, respected ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being part of this solemn ceremony this morning. We're going to start right away. My name is Uchi Tambanso. I'm going to be your master of ceremony for this moment. We're going to start with the national anthems of Cameroon and the United States of the United States of America.
Entrusted in me as President, Board of Trustees of the ICT University, I hereby constitute this assembly into a congregation
led by eminent professors to think out of the box, to be non-conformists, and who are continual researchers to renovate and innovate, to challenge the status quo towards the improvement of an existing system and nation building. As Aristotle, the philosopher, once said, good government is not a work of chance, but of science and purpose. Today, we present to you purposeful scientists in the area of information and communication technology, information systems and networking, computer science, software engineering, business management and sustainable development, accounting information technology, banking and finance, accounting, science of education, international masters in business management and sustainable development, masters in accounting, PhD in business administration, PhD in information and communication technology. Mr. President of the Board of Trustees, we have given these candidates knowledge and built skills into them through the technology which you and our partners have provided. coupled with our experience and knowledge, for knowledge is power, as was once said by Sir Francis Bacon. We pray that our students win dignity and strive towards the improvement and the innovation of existing structures towards the eminence in Africa as they stamp out corruption and poverty towards the enhancement of human dignity. We have not trained them to be knowledge reproduction officers, but knowledge creators to make a difference in the society. Dear graduating students and candidates, today you move into the world of thoughts, ideas, and governance as you strive to make a difference and settle down and probably be submerged into the existing systems. Remember this statement from Aristotle. A good state is not the work of fortune, but of knowledge and purpose. A state is good only when those citizens who have a share in the government are themselves good. Have a stake in whatever you do is done in life. Dear parents, sponsors, and well-wishers, we are very proud of you and wish to express our gratitude for your engagement in the training of these young Africans. It has been a wonderful sacrifice on your part, and today you are proud to see the achievements of these young men and women. Continue to accompany us on the journey with these students, a journey which has long started. I pray the Lord to bless all your efforts and pray that your good plans for these young Africans graduating today may never go in vain. Let me, at this occasion, acknowledge a particular family that has come thousands of miles away to accompany their daughter receive her PhD today. Let us welcome the mother and the aunt of one of our students, the doctor to be, Dr. Samale. Samale, can you rise up and see you and your mother and her sister? Where are they? And your children. We are very proud of you. Continue to do so, and God will bless your efforts. These and many others have sacrificed a lot, and may your sacrifices never go in vain. And may God bless your efforts and grant out all that you have planned to happen for your children will happen as from today hence. May God bless all of us. Long live our cooperation, long live the ICT University, long live Africa. And your children, we are very proud of you. Continue to do so, and God will bless your efforts. These and many others have sacrificed a lot, and may your sacrifices never go in vain. And may God bless your efforts and grant out all that you have planned to happen for your children will happen as from today hence. May God bless all of us. Long live our cooperation, long live the ICT University, long live Africa. Yeah.
Technology. He has a GPA of 3.84. Can we come? I'm going to call the students to please line up here so that will be faster while we get the awards ready. Information Systems and Networking, Fu Herbert Su, with a GPA of 3.625. Software Engineering, Imam Rahab Mohammed, 3.88. Computer Science, Chi Michael Che, with a GPA of 3.02. Can you clap for me?
Best student in Computer Science. Best student in Software Engineering.
Imam Rajab Mohammed.
Best student in Accounting.
Babit Jason.
Best student in Business Management and Sustainability.
Midlas Sudisia.
We have the best student in Information Systems and Networking.
Full Hebrew.
Banking and Finance.
Shiwo Jimmy Miriam Nangu.
Thank you. We have the award for the best student in ICT for class of 2018.
Overall best student.
Overall best student in ICT for class of 2018. Let's give him a round of applause, please. For best graduating student in Science of Education for 2018 commencement.
Yonta Samudu.
Award for best graduating student in International Business Administration. Best graduating student in International Business Administration. Award for ICT Entrepreneurship and the best software developer for 2018 commencement. ICT Entrepreneurship and best software developer.
My greeting. We are very proud to collaborate with Uganda and Nigeria. We have operations started in Zimbabwe. The ICT University is growing. So we are very honored we prepared an award, a Lifetime Achievement Award for Leadership in Education for Governor Nasi El-Rufai, represented here by the Commissioner of Science and Technology of the State of Kaduna in Nigeria. I'll ask the Honorable Commissioner to come and receive this on behalf of the Governor. We are also honored for a great professor. I look at him more of a professor as opposed to a politician who has proven himself in the world of academia. We are honored as ICT University Board of Trustees to present this Lifetime Achievement Award for Leadership in Education to His Excellency Professor Ike Ikwerimagu. As this is going on, we are also honored to present a Lifetime Achievement Award in Community Education, Science and Technology to the Honorable Commissioner Jafaru Sani.
for us. But sadly, from reports from the World Health Organization shows that around 4.4 million people die from respiratory medical aid. We also have secondary problems like few reliable tools to take rapid diagnosis, too many human errors in hospitals, losing unnecessary lives, little or no awareness about non-communicable diseases, especially in our villages, using our local languages because we use French and English, our grandmothers and grandfathers don't understand them. Late disease discovery. We always discover these diseases late when they are already at the final stage and too late to do something. It usually takes a lot of time to have diagnosis, especially in these test centers in town. We need to have tickets wait for hours in order to get diagnosis. But it is not hopeless. We designed a solution called Diagnos, a mobile application which uses artificial intelligence and big data to diagnose, detect, prevent, and predict respiratory diseases in less than 10 minutes, then connect patients with doctors, both locally and remote communication system, so that we have 6 million internet users in Cameroon. But if one person is having a smartphone in a community, at least the person can help diagnose and detect diseases to 3 people around him, making a projection of around 18 million people total available reach in the country. And this can be going to billions in African territory. This is not over. Though the application is not yet in the market, we already have 4 awards.
And thank you. We thank God for this graduation ceremony. I have always said this, every time we have a graduation is probably the top highlight of our institution, because we can say all we want to do, but if we are keeping students just studying and never finishing, we have not accomplished anything. So we thank God for the 5th graduation ceremony of the ICT University. I know when I say the 5th, some of you will be like, the Cameroon is just the 2nd. However, my great friend Professor Wasswa Balunyo did a coup d'etat and captured 3 other graduations for the Uganda campus. I thank him for that. Professor Wasswa Balunyo, please let us recognize him. I want to take this opportunity to give glory to God for this graduation ceremony. Without him, none of this will happen. ICT University strongly believes in its Christian values and the fact that without God we are nothing. And I want to really take this opportunity. I'm an African. I know people look at me as an American professor, but I'm still in Africa. I cannot continue without thanking my father who is sitting there. I want us to give him a clap. My dad and my hero, Mr. George Marita, and my mom, Minister of Higher Education, represented here by an outstanding scholar himself, a professor, the Secretary General. Thank the presence here of His Excellency Ike Ekweremadu, Professor Ike Ekweremadu. Please let's give him a clap for taking time. We thank you, Prof. He's not just a professor attached to ICT University, he's also a professor attached to Southern University in Louisiana. We really want to thank the delegation that came with him. Can you stand up so we recognize you that came with His Excellency, please? The delegation that accompanies Excellency, please, we thank you for coming. The Nigerian government has been very supportive of what we do, I must say that. We have a lot of support from Nigeria. We are honored that we'll be launching a new campus beginning in the state of Kaduna and working with Excellency Ekweremadu, highly possibly in the city of Abuja. I hope you will confirm my words, but that is based on his advice also. And I am glad to announce that the state of Kaduna, just how good these people are actually working to donate over 100 hectares of land freely to ICT University. Another beauty to start ISU, if you don't mind, stand up. We thank you, Professor Tanko. Thank you all. all the people from Kaduna, we thank you.
I want to take this opportunity
Professor Jacques Kamundongo, who is unavoidably absent, and who was given me this position. Assistant President of ICT University, Professor Victor Mbarika, the Vice Chancellor and his collaborators for the quality education they are providing within this institution, in respect of some of the canons of the Bachelor's Master's Software System, quality assurance, professionalization, employability, comparability, and you can name the rest. And I want to use this opportunity to congratulate you most especially for the academic mobility, the level of academic mobility that takes place within that institution. That proves that it has a good vision, and God willing, it will take our candidates several directly to the sky. I think we all know the sky is your limits. I also like to thank his parents who are here present. Professor, congratulations. I hope you and your parents are still working. You're looking very strong and energetic. You have to continue using your wisdom so God can continue blessing you as well. To the parents and guardians of today's graduates, I wish to thank you for the investment you've put in your children. I know, as the president said, you've saved everything except money. Yeah, sometimes it gets very unbearable, but trust me, if you want to know the cost of education, I would advise you to verify the cost of ignorance first. dear students, graduating students, you are today doctors, perhaps master's degree graduates and degree holders. I have noticed from the exhibitions that we just saw from the output in the field, the education you're receiving here is one of the best and the finest. Mr. President, I want to encourage you to register your students for the next Genius and Talent Exhibition show that takes place during the University Games. Because from what I've just seen, it's a decision that was put in place by the President of Columbia Head of State, where students are excited to use their talent to demonstrate what they can do with them. And as in the ICT domain, they are very versed in that. The advantage of that project is that it helps them put in place junior enterprises and eventually incubators. These are all issues that fall within the framework of the new university governance policy, prescribed by His Excellency Paul Biya, President of the Head of State, applied under the coordination of the Prime Minister Head of Government, His Excellency Mr. Philemon Yan. The organizers of this wonderful ceremony, I say thank you and congratulations. And to our choristers for their beautiful voices, I want to thank them for providing the much needed flavor for this wonderful ceremony. The music is very good food to the brain and to the spirits. It is an honor that I wish to thank, as I thank our graduates, I wish you, I want to ask you to be daring, I want to ask you to be courageous. You're confronting a new world tomorrow, and you have to know as one thing you have to avoid in life is fear. Because one American president said, the greatest fear of humankind is fear itself. Long live the higher education system, long live private institutes of higher education, long live ICT University, long live interstate international cooperation within ICT with the US, Nigeria, Uganda, Burkina Faso, Cameroon, and I'm sure there are a lot more. Long live the Minister of Higher Education, long live His Excellency Paul Biya, President of Public Head of State, Architect of the new University Governance Policy, long live our dear, peaceful and beloved country, Cameroon, united in its diversity. Thank you for your very kind.
But I'm Cameroonian education because my mother is Cameroonian. I want to say something to those, all those who are ready today, especially those who are going to work with the private sector. This is the first part of the fight. The next part is going to concern getting a job, and that one will be stronger than what you've already gone through. So I would like to give some advice on the nocturnal job creation consultant that is working at night. And Africa, we don't work at night. Everything that can be done during the day can also be done during the night. So try and explore the nocturnal economy. It's not easy for us in Africa today. We are trying to create an economic system that will take part of the night in Africa. So we want to create jobs. Thank you. Come on, the world.
You guys are meant to go far.
So go far. This is the topic.
Well, I have the privilege of closing the remarks and observations. I'm mindful of what Professor Ebere Madu told us. He told us something that is very important, which is a message that I leave with all the graduating students I've had for 6 years of teaching at the higher education level. Remember, I told you that once he was able to write down the degrees that he would like to have, LLB, BL, PhD, and so on, when he had none yet, and was determined to work towards them, and he did. So what happened? He was dreaming, and dreaming high. And the message I want to leave with you, students and graduates, is that you should always have a dream. Dream, dream, and dream. And above all, never allow your dream to die. Thank you.
I should let you know with some excitement that we are gradually moving to the crux of today's matter. And probably this is the best moment to call on the man of God to give us a word of prayer as we prepare to hand over the degrees. I'm going to call on the Lord Bishop Agu to please come over here and pray for us.
Our Father and our God, you made us in your image. You created us with a purpose. At creation, you gave us opportunity to become what you want us to be. Though we failed you, through your Son Jesus Christ, you brought us back, and giving us the right opportunity to honor you and to live our purposes in fullness. Thank you for what we are seeing today. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for the instruments you've been using. And thank you for the challenges we are going with. Lord, we can do nothing without you. Unless you help us, we will fail. So, Lord God, we pray for your grace. We pray for your guidance. We pray, O Lord, that your light will shine in the dark parts of our lives. Grant, O God, that through what you are doing here in this school, Africa will become what you want it to be, giving us the right leaders and right leadership, moving in the right path and becoming what you want us to be. Lord, we commit everyone in this hall, especially the graduates, into your hands. Their future is in your hands. Grant, O God, that they will prosper. Grant, O God, that they will become what you want them to be. Bless every soul here. Let the staff of this institution, we pray especially for your servant, Professor Victor, giving him the missionary spirit. Come back to Africa and rebuild Africa. Raise more men like him. Strengthen him and give him the needed grace to carry out the visions. We have been challenged to dream dreams, to have visions. Open our eyes to Lord, our spiritual eyes to see beyond where we are. Give us strength to pursue the same. This is our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, sir. I'm not going to call on the official.
Mr. President, sir, I now call upon the Dean of the ICT Department to present the candidate, in information communication technology, information systems networking, software engineering, and computer science for the award of a bachelor's degree of the ICT University.
Mr. President, sir, allow me to present to you the names of the students that have satisfied the requirements for the award of a Bachelor of Science degree in Information and Communication Technology. Ademolati Samuel Damola, Njogbo Mbakob Elisa Varel, Kankon Isaac Stephen, Abdulkadir Muhammad Tawhid, Jason Resilian, Ngringon Aryuda David Quincy Brenda, Yerima Ahmed, Melvin Maureen Abongwa, Ntumu Kabuche Collins, Sufuru Kriam Clever, Kaisis for John Dungong, Ashu Ebot Ivrik Oben, Fanga Angie Ani, Mwanyo Mbajon Landry Florin, Rabio Ashiaku. Mr. President, sir, allow me to present to you the names of the students that have satisfied Nadia Dati, Fu Habat Su, Haruna Ibrahim Usman, Bezese Felix Yuslin, Okuro Chinedu Moshe Dayan, Abongo Sariki Ugu, Mohamed Abdallah, Renzi Bonsom Mako, Wopi Gengwe Joskel Mirel, E.K. Daniel Chuku Emeka, Oguin Kevin Bless, Shakara Ngubo, Bate Clinton Eyon, Zeren Bilun Zeren. Mr. President, sir, allow me to present to you the names of the students that have satisfied the requirements for the award of a degree in Bachelor of Chief Michael Chu. Mr. President, sir, allow me to present to you the names of the students that have satisfied the requirements for the award of a Bachelor of Science in Software Engineering. Phobia Ngamba Gerald, Tompo Mafo Manon Delan, Abdullahi Muhammad, Imam Rajab Muhammad, Mba Cedric Mba, Baye Kamanda Ekpit, Yankan.
Mr. President, sir, I now call upon the Dean of the Department of Business Management and Sustainability to present the candidates for the award of most.
Yange Ganton. Makundu Kamke Mijori. Nera Tajoria Beniti Oma. Otto Bakta Grace Devon. Senatu Yaya. Che Nisapon Niko Nanda. Prince Lasu Dasia Libet Kevin. Marco Nagesh Azi. She's earning happiness from the guest. The program accounting, Echo Winter Mixing, Vivi Jessin Tiku, Tatan Tada Aror, Accounting Information Technology, J. Siri Kelly, Gert Rodriguez. Glenn Munakwa Romario Rousseau. Asan Eric Jumia Miriam Nambu. Tewa William Portabe.
The candidate is who have obtained the master's degree.
I want to present to you this candidate who has satisfied the requirements for the award of a Master's Degree of International Business from the ICT University.
For all their hard working and what they have been doing for us, We know the success is not just a straight path. It's true. During our studies there, we had some challenges, but they have always tried all they can to make it a better place for us. I think my project for the next year is I'm actually working with my to finalize the documents for the company. I intend to put in place ICT solution to save Africa. And I think ICT will be one of our best targets to put in place an information system that could. City vient de finir avec la cérémonie de remise des diplômes officiels. C'était vraiment une agréable cérémonie. Nous remercions tout le staff de ICT, toute l'équipe derrière toute cette préparation, les invités qui sont venus de très loin aussi. Nous remercions aussi nos parents qui nous avaient permis de finir notre formation sans ambiguïté. Et nous ne pouvons que dit qu'en ce stade où nous nous trouvons, nous sommes prêts pour montrer ce que nous avons appris en classe sur le terrain. Et je pouvais de cette occasion pour dire que je suis en train de mettre sur pied une entreprise qui s'appelle The Best Group, qui a pour vision de servir l'Afrique en général avec des solutions IT pour aider que ce soit les entreprises, des PME, des organismes internationaux et autres, et des établissements secondaires et supérieurs à gérer les activités en utilisant des solutions adéquates à la pointe des technologies.
Et vous avez été premier,
J'ai eu un bachelor's en software engineering. Oui, bachelor's of science in software engineering. Ouais.